Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the ultraviolet blacklight effect. For your convenience, I provided this photo, but feel free to use another photo if you like. Its link is in my video's description or project files. To save time, I also provided the shape of the sunglasses, which we'll use later. Before we begin, smash that subscribe button to let you know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials. The first step is to make a selection around the subject. There are many ways to do this, however, for this example, let's use our quick selection tool. Make its radius 10 pixels. If you're using CC 2018 or later, click the Select Subject button. It does a relatively good job automatically selecting our subject. To fill in areas it didn't select, just drag your tool over them. If you're using an earlier version, drag your tool over your entire subject. To remove areas of the selection, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over them. To refine soft or feathery areas like hair, go to Select. If you're using a version earlier than CC 2015.5, click Refine Edge. For later versions, click Select and Mask. If you prefer to use Refine Edge, shift-click Select and Mask. I did in-depth tutorials on both of these filters, so if you'd like to watch them, I provided their links as well. Check Smart Radius. This detects smooth and hard edges. To adjust the size of your brush, make sure the Caps Lock key is off and press the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. Brush over the edge of the hair and other areas to refine its edges. Feather it 1 pixel to soften the edges a bit, and check Decontaminate Colors. This prevents the background colors and tones from bleeding into the edges of our subject. Drag it to 100%. Output it to a new layer with Layer Mask. We'll create a black background under the active layer by Control or Command clicking the New Layer icon. Check your foreground and background colors. If they aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Since black is our foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Make the layer mask active and open your brush tool and brush picker. Pick a soft round brush. Let's make its size 1400 pixels to start. Its hardness is 0%, the opacity is 50%, and the flow is 100%. Click over the head 2 or 3 times. Reduce the brush's size and click again. Continue adjusting its size to gradually reveal the original background of your photo directly behind the head. Make your subject active and go to Filter, Distort, and Diffuse Glow. The graininess is 0, the glow amount is 2, and the clear amount is 10. We'll convert our image into a smart object so we can continue to add filters to it non-destructively. To do this, shift-click the bottom layer to make all the layers active, and click the icon at the upper right. Click Convert to Smart Object. Click the adjustment layer icon, and click Brightness Contrast. Drag the brightness to minus 150 and the contrast to plus 100. Open the Adjustments panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Adjustments. Click the Hue Saturation icon. Check Colorize. For the hue, type in 220, the saturation 33, and the lightness minus 20. Open the Adjustments panel again and click the Levels icon. For the input midtones, type in 0.65, and for the input highlights, type in 200. For the output highlights, type in 210. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Solid Color. In the hexadecimal field, type in 110094. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Change its blend mode to color dodge. Next, we'll add glows to the skin and teeth. Make a new layer. And let's name it Highlights. Change its blend mode to Overlay. With your brush tool active, press X to invert the foreground and background colors so white is your foreground color. Reduce the brush's size approximately this much and reduce its opacity to 50%. Brush above and below the sunglasses, the top of the nose, and the teeth. Next, we'll make the sunglasses glow to the UV light. Open your Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Control or Command click the thumbnail of the glasses channel to select its shape. Open back the Layers panel and make your subject active. Press Control or Command J to cut the inside of the selection and copy it to its own layer. Then deselect it by pressing Control or Command J. We'll jump the cutout glasses to the top of the Layers panel by pressing Control or Command and the right bracket key until it's at the top. Convert it into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. Make a copy of it and click the eyeball next to the copy to hide it. Double-click an empty area of the original glasses layer to open the layer style window. Click Outer Glow. If the box isn't white, click it and pick white. The blend mode is linear light, and the opacity is 30%. The technique is softer, the spread is 0%, and the size is 10 pixels. The contour is linear, and the range is 50%. Make the top glasses visible and active. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 1 pixel. Go to Image, Adjustments, and Invert. Go back to Image, Adjustments, and Hue Saturation. Check Colorize. For the hue, type in 210, the saturation is 77, and the lightness is 10 pixels. Make a copy of the copy. Double-click Gaussian Blur of the second copy. If you see this message, it's just letting us know that the other smart filters will be temporarily turned off. Make the blur radius 10 pixels. Double-click Hue Saturation and make the hue 240 and the lightness minus 10. Change the blend mode to screen. Next, we'll add a soft glow around the inside perimeter of the lenses. To save space in the Layers panel, let's collapse the smart filters. Control or Command click the glasses of Layer 1 to select its shape. Press Q to make the selection into a quick mask. Make a new layer. Open your Paint Bucket tool and invert your colors so white is your foreground color. Make sure Contiguous is checked. You'll see the reason in a moment. Click anywhere outside the glasses to delete the quick mask. The reason the shapes of the lenses weren't deleted is because Contiguous was checked. Press Q to revert the quick mask into a selection. Invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command Shift I. We'll fill the selection with black, and since our background color is black, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Then deselect it. Reduce the fill to 0%. This makes the black lens shapes invisible, but it'll retain the layer style effects that we'll be adding to it. Double-click the glasses to open its layer style window. Click Inner Glow. The blend mode is soft light, the opacity is 30%, and the color is white. The technique is softer, the source is edge, the choke is 0%, and the size is 250 pixels. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.